First off, thank you for being here. For those of you who don't know, my name is Dr. Chris Kevel. I'm the Vice Chancellor of Research here at LSU Health Shreveport, as well as the Dean of the School of Graduate Studies. This is our fifth annual research celebration that really highlights and exemplifies some of the best aspects of research that are occurring here on campus. But you can see here in this slide, this is a snapshot of where we are with our research funding to date. You can see where we started was pretty low many years ago, but with a concerted effort, everybody coming together, we really have turned the tide. So far this year, year to date, we're at $25 million in extramural federal research funding coming in. This is from the Departments of Defense, which you see the logo up there, also from NASA, and then more importantly, the National Institutes of Health. And for those of you that may not know, for every federal dollar that comes in, it generates essentially five or more dollars of revenue locally. So this is a significant increase in funding. So what about grants, and what about grant submissions? This is a real simple table that illustrates the number of grant submissions last year compared to this year. And in fact, if you do an annualization of the number of grants, we're actually 21% higher in the number of grant submissions than we were last year. So these are grants that are going out to federal agencies to bring in and attract more money. In addition to grants, we also take the new technologies that we have discovered or revolutionized or invented and convert that to what we call tech transfer. So that's filing patents, that's actually having disclosures that are submitted by faculty, and then once those patents are filed for and the patents are issued, those technologies are licensed out into the private sector. This is all due to the fact that we have numerous research centers. The first one we have up here, up to your upper left there, is the CEAR, the Center for Excellence in Arthritis and Rheumatology. It's a center that's been around for quite some time that our rheumatology fellowship program has been really involved in and critical for. The one to its right is the Feiswiler Cancer Center, a center we're all very familiar with and we all understand the importance of it. And then the one to the FWCC's right is a relatively newer center, the Center for Brain Health. You'll hear a little bit about that later on this evening. The reality is the Center for Brain Health pulls together a lot of neurology and neurosciences capabilities, which actually is growing very rapidly here. In the bottom left here, you see this big heart that looks like an LSU Tiger purple and gold heart. That's our Center of Excellence for Cardiovascular Diseases and Sciences. This is a very large program here that actually is supported by numerous investigators and brings in a large amount of NIH dollars. And then to the right of that is the more recent and newest Center of Excellence, the Center of Excellence for Emerging Viral Threats. As many of you in this room will remember, during the pandemic, we stood up the EVT and then the CEVT, and now, as you'll see later on, it's going to be culminated with new research space in the new building, the new medical education building. And then last but not least, on the far right, is the logo for the Louisiana Addiction Research Center. This is a new center as well, and as we're coming out of the pandemic, we're realizing that part of the problem that we have, not only in all the other diseases that we talked about, but is addiction. We're very fortunate here to have experts in that area, Dr. Nick Getters, Dr. Kevin Mernan, Dr. James Patterson, that have all come together to help create this new center that we believe is really going to have a substantial impact on addiction, not only here, but nationwide. In addition to those centers, we also have a series of what are called NIH Centers of Research Excellence. The abbreviation is COBRE. These Centers of Biomedical Research Excellence are funded by the National Institutes for General Medical Sciences. The first one that's up there is the Center for Molecular and Tumor Virology, and brought in $22.5 million in its lifetime. The middle one is the Center for Redox Biology and Cardiovascular Disease that myself and Wayne Orr and Karen Stokes run, and it's actually in its beginning phase, in phase one, going into phase two. And then we're also very delighted to have a very, very recent center called the Center for Applied Immunology and Pathological Processes that Dr. Andrew Urochko, as well as Matt Woolard and Dr. Rona Scott, who were here earlier but had to leave, are running that, and that's in the beginning of phase one. So ladies and gentlemen, these are poised to be the seed corn for all the crops that we're going to grow that is going to be new research funding.
The mission of clinical research is to really bring our scientific discoveries all the way up to the patient care level. It's really the goal of medicine to defy evolution.
And we do it every day in amazing ways. Vaccines, all the things, antibiotics that we have, we defy evolution. And clinical research is important because it is how we change the status quo in medicine. It's how we change the things that are unacceptable, the deaths due to COVID or other infectious diseases or cancers and the like. Is because of clinical research that we can change those things. And so we have a robust clinical research program here at LSU. We're growing and in a growth phase, I think. Currently, we have over 150 clinical trials ongoing, including those in the Cancer Center as well as throughout the rest of the campus. 62 of those are INCORP trials in the Feistweiler Cancer Center. 53 of those are pharma-sponsored clinical trials.
On behalf of the Office of Research, I'm presenting this year's Excellence in Extramural Funding Award. This award recognizes the research faculty member with the largest amount of annual direct cost funding for extramural funding sources. For the current fiscal year, 22-23, this year's recipient is Dr. Martin Sapp. Dr. Sapp received a new R01 grant from the NIH through a competing continuation mechanism. His new R01 award provides an annual total cost of $448,000 per year for 5 years and $2,240,000 over the life of the project. His current research project involves tracking the HPV particles and the development of a new infectious models focusing on entry processes for HPV.
Every year it's a tough decision to choose one winner for an innovation award. However, I'm pleased to announce that Dr. Patrick Massey and his team with Dr. Giovanni Salitro, Dr. Wayne Scalisi, Dr. Cora Montgomery are the winners for their outstanding work in the creation of a modular simulator training system for surgeons. The system is comprised of a low-cost 3D printed materials and digital training models that can be customized and downloaded digitally, yielding the potential to revolutionize surgical training globally. Their product advantage over competitors is that modules can be sent through the internet and printed out in a matter of hours. This is a game changer in terms of accessibility and cost effectiveness. The tactile feedback provided by the 3D printing of complex surgical procedures will surely result in quality outcomes for patient care. Join me in congratulating Dr. Massey and his team for their innovative work and dedication to improving the lives of their patients.
Translational research takes scientific discoveries made in the laboratory, in the clinic, or in the field, and transforms them into new treatments and approaches to medical care that improve the health of the community. Translational research includes two areas of translation. One is the process of applying discoveries generated during research in the laboratory and in preclinical studies to the development of trials and studies in human beings. The second area of translation concerns research aimed at enhancing the adoption of best practices in the community. Cost effectiveness of prevention and treatment strategies is also an important part of translational science. LSU Health Science Center recognizes this important work through the Excellence in Translational Research Award. I would like to take just a moment to mention two recent publications that highlight the work of tonight's recipient and his colleagues. The first compared the incidence of bacterial co-infections with in-hospital mortality rates in COVID-19 patients and found an increased risk of mortality when such co-infections were present. The second showed how data from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and a tool called the Social Vulnerability Index could identify at-risk populations to better direct public resources to decrease health disparities. Please join me in extending a round of applause to the recipient of the Excellence in Translational Research Award, Dr. Nobel Bouillon. The research of tonight's recipient of the Research Rising Star Award focuses on the role of one particular enzyme and the role that it plays in decreased cerebral blood flow, neuroinflammation, mitochondrial dysfunction, and neurological deficits after cardiac arrest. He is a past recipient of a Career Development Award from the American Heart Association and currently is the recipient of an NIH R01 award totaling $1.46 million over 4 years. Please join me in extending a round of applause to the recipient of the Research Rising Star Award, Dr. Reggie Lee.
I honestly could not be more excited to present this year's Community Champion Award. I can't think of a person more deserving. She has been an outstanding advocate for research and science for our campus and the entire Caddo-Bossier community and throughout the state of Louisiana. This individual has inspired many young adults to love science. This year's Community Champion Award recipient is Ms. Chris Clements. Ms. Clements started the Bobby Hicks Smart Program here on campus over 20 years ago. This program provides a year-long research experience with investigators at LSU Health Shreveport for academically advanced high school seniors who have a career interest in medicine, biomedical research, and biomedical engineering. More than 200 students have participated in this SMART program, and often these SMART students select careers in medicine and science. Please join me in congratulating Chris Clements as our 2023 Community Champion.
We have two senior faculty members that this year will retire. We will lose them, we will miss them, but we're not gonna let them go far away, I promise you. And as you can see here, the two distinguished career service awards that we have this evening are for Dr. Ken McMartin, who is here with us tonight for over 42 years of service. Dr. McMartin is not only in the Department of Pharmacology, Toxicology, and Neuroscience, but he is a card-carrying toxicologist, as well as pharmacologist. His work in the study of methylglyoxal and its impact on kidney disease and kidney dysfunction is huge. And as if that wasn't enough, Dr. McMartin has been continuously funded through either NIH or Department of Defense-based grants, NSF-based grants, over the 42 years that he's been here. So Dr. McMartin, thank you so much for all the work that you've done, the students that you've trained, and the impact that you've made in science. Our other honoree, Dr. Kevin McCarthy, couldn't be here with us tonight, but I told him I would tell you a little bit about him anyways. He first started off in creating the research division in the Department of Pathology that has since grown to new heights and is actually being led by Wayne Orr. And in fact, Dr. McCarthy has been delighted to have recruited such wonderful faculty to grow the research division in pathology. From there, he went on to become the chair of the Department of Cell Biology and Anatomy, where he has reinvigorated anatomical sciences as well as research in the Department of Cell Biology and Anatomy, and has actually worked very closely not only with those researchers here but educators here to be able to put our campus on the forefront for education in medical sciences and research. So join me in thanking Dr. McCarthy for his service. Let's talk about the future. I'm delighted to tell you tonight, this is just a handful of new faculty researchers that we have recruited to our campus within the past 12 to 18 months. These are 11 new faculty, some of them here are new chairmen, Dr. Jordan, who's down at the bottom left-hand corner there, Dr. Al Fayadi, as well as Dr. Omar Franco, Dr. Rohit Jangra, came to us from Princeton. Ladies and gentlemen, I will tell you, this represents the best of the best in the nation. They're all leading the way, not only in new grants coming into the institution, but new areas of research that we're embarking upon, and a direct impact not only to the fiscal and research education mission here, but to the community, because they make a difference, not only to the students, but also to the citizens. The other thing that we're really, really excited about is the new BSL-3 facility. And we have many individuals coming from across the nation, as well as Florida and other places, to tell us more about BSL-3 capabilities and technologies and to learn what we could do perhaps in collaboration with them. So stay tuned. Coming this September, it's going to be exciting. And one of the things that I'm also very excited to share with you today, hot off the presses, and I think Dr. Disbrow is right over there, is a very exciting announcement. As Dr. Vancheri mentioned a moment ago, our clinical trials outreach has really been a game changer nationwide because we recruit everybody that gets impacted by disease. We demonstrated that with the vaccine. So much so, Dr. Disbrow and her team at the Center for Brain Health has now basically executed and started an agreement with the Michael J. Fox Foundation to be part of the Black PD study. We're one of only five universities in the nation, ladies and gentlemen, that are part of this. In the South, it's us, UAB, and Emory. That's a pretty great company to be in, and this is just kicking off. And so next year, I have a feeling we'll hear a lot more about this from Dr. Disbro. So congratulations. I'd like to also share with you is that we're going to have a new website coming out that's going to allow you to get all this information and more. One of the key things that we believe in here in the research office and operations is communicating and sharing all the good work with not only people here at LSU Health, but everybody in the community and beyond. And lastly, I'd like to thank you all. I'd like to thank you for your dedication, not only to LSU Health Shreveport, not only to the students that we train, but also to the region. As you can see here, I hope tonight you've recognized that research impacts a whole host of different aspects of not only our campus, but also our region and our state. So thank you all very much. Have a good evening and drive safe.